As you probably know, we talk a lot on this program about food as medicine. But my next guest says if we want to get the most out of our fruits and veggies, we have to choose the right varieties. This is very important. Joe Robinson is the author of Eating on the Wild Side, The Missing Link to Optimum Health. You know, I think this is going to probably change the way that I buy my groceries now, reading this book.
I hope so.
you say that we've been breeding the nutrition out of our foods, not just for the last 50 or 100 years, but for 10,000 years.
That's right. We used to eat wild plants and wild game and for like 98% of our time on this planet. And then 10,000 years ago, we became farmers. And basically, we looked at each other and said, hey, we can do better than this bitter food that we're eating and this chewy, tough food. Let's grow garden. Let's go gardening. But what we did was we selected the sweetest, the lowest in fiber, the lowest in antioxidants, and highest in sugar foods that we could find because we liked the way they tasted, same as we do today.
I think this is so timely. And you've brought some examples here. Again, these are common foods that people might buy. What should we know about some of these foods?
Something important to know is that plants are not creating these antioxidants for us. They're doing it because they have to defend themselves against the sun and other external threats.
That's a good point.
And they do it by creating, like these are two apples. These are both Galus, same kind. But this one grew with full exposure to the sun, and it had to create all this botanical sunscreen, all these anthocyanins. And this one was shaded. It didn't have to create, didn't have to produce those. So when we eat this redder one, then we absorb that protection and it protects us.
That's a great tip. So just the skin itself here is full of the good stuff you're talking about.
Exactly. Most of the nutrients in most foods are in the skin because that's what is exposed to the elements and where plants have to, you know, have that first line of defense.
Right. I love my salad, so I'm interested what you say here.
This is the most popular salad in green in the United States. We make
iceberg.
450 million metric tons a year. This is iceberg. Now, what we need to know here is that these leaves on the outside have a fair amount of antioxidants, but in the inside, they have been sheltered from the sun, and so they have 1/100th as much.
Wow.
So that's why this...
1%, you're saying.
That's right. So that's why...
And that's the part that everyone eats.
So this is a very low nutrient lettuce, and it's our most popular. What people need to look for is one that has open leaves, exposed to the sun. Here's that botanical sunscreen. And when we eat it, then we get protection against inflammation and cancer, all these things that antioxidants are proving to be important
for.
That's
a great tip. Great tip. What about carrots?
Oh, this is also a good example. A lot of people are eating these baby carrots.
Right.
And they're not baby carrots. They're big carrots that are misshapen, and they're just trying to, you know, use them up and, you know, make not have to throw them away. So they just whittle them down until they're this shape. But they've gotten rid of that outer part that is the most nutritious. In fact, if you just peel a carrot, put the peels here and the carrot there, the peels are as nutritious as what you have left. And so they've whittled this down to the point where there's very little left.
And again, this is presumably in the interest of trying to make it more palatable, more tasty, and in the process of taking away the nutritious value.
That's right. I mean, it's looked as a good economic move, which it is.
Yeah.
But now we're learning that it's taking away the medicine.
It's a great book. I think people are going to change the way they buy their food. I know that I will. Thank you very much.
Thank you.